Hey guys, Nightworks Media here. Right now, we're planning to install itong DDPI Z40 dashcam kasi matagal nang walang dashcam tong kotse na to, and alam nyo naman kung gaano ka-importante ngayon sakali ang magkaroon ng isang dash camera, lalo't araw-araw ka nagda-drive, in and out ka ng Metro Manila, or you're just simply going to work every day. So, samahan nyo ako, install natin itong dual channel dash camera by DDPI Z40. Alright guys, unboxing portion tayo. This is the rear dash camera for Z40 ng DDPI. It has 1080p, can rotate 360 degrees. Flexible ang installation pero we prefer na sa likod nyo ilagay para namamonitor nyo just in case na may mga bangga. And here we go, we have the front camera as you can see on the box. Very premium. The unit itself, napakaganda. Comes along with the instruction manual and then an extra 3M tape for adhesive purposes. So, kinaganda ng front camera, it's 1944p. It has the Sony IMX335 sensor. And it's very good for low light conditions, lalo pag gabi. High resolution for sharper details, which is makita mo mga license plates in most cases. And as you can see, very minimal lang din yung itsura niya. Napakaliit lang. Halos kasing size lang ng palad ko. And also, pwede mo siya i-tilt up and down. It has also dual channel storage in case masira ang SD card, meron tong backup na internal. 24-hour parking monitor, which is sold separately for the hardware kit. May Wi-Fi capability para ma-access mo yung DDPI app using your smartphone. And also has loop recording and then time-lapse function. So basically, you got the screen here. So ang installation nito is usually sa windshield, pag ganon. But let me show you first yung interface. Again, hindi to touchscreen, so kahit anong pindot mo. Power button or screen saver kung gusto mo ng walang display. And then you got your gallery. So nandyan ang front and rear albums, hiwalay sila. The one that says R, yan yung rear. May option ka rin to off.
Audio recording off.
Yan. What happens there is hindi maririnig yung kahit anong audio feedback inside sa kotse. And then you got your settings for speakers, microphone, on and off. Startup sound kung ayaw mo yung pag nag-on yung mismong dashcam at nagsasalita yung AI ng DDPI. Camera switch kung gusto mo makita yung rear, then gusto mo makita yung view from rear. Screensaver, and then you got your choices ng resolution, which is 1944p. Dalawa lang naman siya, yung isa is 1080p. Collision sensitivity, time-lapse parking mode. Then calibration, ito yung may guide ka kung ano yung itsura once you install it. Then format, yung factory default settings niya. Format is for your SD card. Wi-Fi is for yung application ng DDPI na naka-install sa phone mo. So install na natin siya para makita natin kung paano magiging output. Ito yung front camera muna. Best place to install yung ating dashcam is usually underneath ng rear view mirror. Ang output niyan is always, you'll follow itong calibration niya, which is nakalagay naman dyan kung ano yung horizon mo and then yung middle line. So let's go ahead and stick it na sa salamin. And again, you want to leave room din pala. Kasi again, hindi natitilt yung mismong camera. So if any case gusto mo ma-check yung LCD, ang hirap kung medyo alam mo yung rear view mirror mo nakaharang nasa taas. Dito lang tayo magbe-base. Okay. So, easy install din yung wires niya kasi when you purchase yung Z40, may kasama siyang ganito. So, purpose lang naman niya is to push yung wires inside. Okay guys, so i-install natin naman yung rear camera. Light indicator niya na naka-on siya kasi nakasaksak na siya sa front. And then, meron tayo yung app. So, pwede mo siya makita through the app yung live feed niya. As you can see in the app, ngayon, kinaganda ng rear camera kasi is 360 siya. Pwede mo siyang iikot-ikot. Kunyari, pagkatikit mo, hindi mo nakuha yung tamang pwesto niya. So, natitwist siya up and down. Yan. Let's get yung pinakamagandang view, which is usually ganyan. So that if in any case, may trouble, sa'yo bumangga, kitang-kita yung likod mo. Para sa akin yan yung pinakamagandang view. Lino, no? Not bad. And again, yung kotse walang tint yan. So, mas kita pa yan. So, since yung DDPI Z40 is using yung Sony sensors niya sa lenses, As you can see, pag yung paligid niya, nag-auto-adjust yung brightness. So hindi siya overexposed, hindi rin siya underexposed.
Here's a sample audio output from inside the car, windows down, and for me, sounds is very crispy and clear, not bad for its audio quality.
Idol, ang plano natin dito? Sabi ko, di kaya nga ikaw pinupunto ko kasi ikaw hahatol, anong tingin mo?
Ito naman yung sample video niya. Balanced yung colors niya. It's very stable as well. Good enough for city driving. Kita yung mga details like yung mga plate number. So it's very important. And then we got the rear camera. Very detailed, very stable. Not bad for 1080p resolution. Here we have yung sample naman paggabi. The only difference is yung lights. Again, it really depends dun sa kotse kung saan nyo i-install. Say for example, yung akin yung gamit kong windshield, medyo glary na dahil sa mga gasgas. So, clarity would still depend dun sa windshield ng kotse nyo. And here we have yung rear camera paggabi. With the 1.8 aperture, it really helps big time, lalo sa mga low light situation like this one.
So, to protect yourself from any driving accidents on the road, make sure to invest in a good brand like the DD Pi and get yourself Z40 Dual Channel Dash Camera. And again, this is Nightworks Media reminding you, always drive safe. Peace.